At 0 months, how much money is in the account? 0 months have gone by, how much money in the account?
1250 or zero?
100.
Oh, wait.
Mm-hmm.
I hear 100, I hear 1250.
100.
It's
100.
It's 100.
You start out with 100.
Good. I can see that there's some confusion there, but it says in the problem, it states in the problem that we start with $100. After 1 month, how much is going to be in the bank account?
112 dollars and 50 cents.
About after 2 months. Kelly?
125.
So, like, we start out at 100, and then we just move on from there. We just add on to that. Right? So it's like 100 plus some amount.
Yeah.
How do we calculate the amount that we have after X months? We calculate how much money we add on after X months.
100 plus 1250 times X.
Perfect.
There you go, Kelly. Come on.
100 plus 1250 times X.
I got some money.
We start with 100, and in the first month we add on 1250. After 2 months, we're going to add on $25. After 3 months, we're going to have $100 that we started with plus 1250 times 3 months, so that'll be 137.50.
Yeah.
137.50. Yeah. So every month, what happens?
You add 1250.
You gain 1250 in that account.
Interesting.
Look at that. There is a linear equation. Most of the time, it's written in this order, but it doesn't make any difference. 12.5x plus 100 or 100 plus 12.5x, it doesn't matter. Then it asks us, okay, it says to graph it. In writing our equation, we found some data points, right? At 0 months, we have $100, so let's call it $100 right there. Start at $100. Then after 1 month, how much money do we have?
112.50,
which should be just a little bit more than 100, like right about there. And after 2 months, how much do we have?
125.
And that's just like 1 month goes by, we have 1250 more, which puts us at 125. And every month that goes by, we already said this, every month that goes by, what happens?
Goes up. 50.
So it's up 1250. So if we go by another month, up another 1250. Another month goes by, up another 1250. And I could do this forever. It'd be pretty boring. It's already kind of boring, so it'd get really boring after infinity time. Okay. And it just keeps growing, and there doesn't seem to be any end in sight. Okay. So this says, how many months will it take to save enough money to buy 10 acres of land on Mars? And the thing that you don't see if you don't have your book open, and that's fine, is that there's this little sign over here, and it says 10 acres on Mars for $175. You can buy 10 acres. So how much money do you need to buy 10 acres?
$175,
right? We're going to keep adding money to this account every month until it gets up to how much?
$175.
So how will we figure out, aside from just going up and up and up until we get to 175, aside from that, how can we figure out how many months it'll take to get up to 175?
Turn into equation.
3, 6.
How so?
6, 12.
Nope. That's the equivalent of just going up and up and up, just guessing and guessing and guessing. Without guessing. What's that? What would that equation look like?
What's that? 100 plus.
Brad gets $175.
Plus something.
Plus something equals 175. That seems to make sense. We need to add money to our $100 to get up to 175. What is this missing piece?
Something six.
X.
X.
It's so many.
Not X. X is just the number of months they go by.
Shh. Number of months it takes.
Oh, 1250.
1250? Just 1250?
X.
1250X. This equation gives us a total amount of dollars. This all adds up to a total. And what is the total we want to get to? So this adds up to the total, right? And the total needs to be $175. Right? Okay, so 175 is the total, which is the exact same as this equation, and how do we figure out how many months it takes? Subtract 100, both sides. If we start with 100, then all the extra money that we need to make is going to be $75, right? We're going to make $75. So how do we get X?
12 times 6.
No.
5. 75 divided by 1250. 6 months. So it seems like everybody was on board with, if I plug in a number of months, it'll tell me how much money I have. I pick this problem because it makes us go backwards. It says, I want to have this much money. How long will that take? How many months will that take? Okay. So then we tell Y what to be, and then we solve for X. We find out how many months it takes to get that much money. Okay. Question? Cool.
I was going to ask if we could do the other one too.
I'm not going to do your entire all right, so if you didn't already have your notes out, you should have your notes out. It's just a word to the wise. You should have a math notebook. You should have a math section of your binder. I look around and I see just loose pieces of paper. I think that's never going to make it home. I'm never going to look at that again. And it's going to be no help to you. And when you complain that I'm so confused, I don't know what to do, I have no idea, I'm not surprised. Because you don't take notes, or if you do, it's never been seen by you again. Well, let's get past this screen. So in your notes, you really should have your notes all the time, but especially right now, you should have your notes. And we should say, maybe take these out so you don't have to get distracted by these. The homework was an example of, like, the reverse of this. There were two examples. Two stories. It had stories to start with, and we went into equations. Here's an equation. I want you to write a story. Now, looking for a specific kind of story, okay? And I want you to think of a story. I want you to say, like, oh, you know, X represents this thing, and Y represents the total amount of whatever. It could represent dollars, it could represent pounds, or apples, or let's see, what was the other one? In the two homework problems, in both examples, Y represented dollars. Okay. I want you to tell, it does not have to be elaborate, it does not even have to be as long as the examples in the book, it's just try and tell me a story that goes along with this equation.
My book is $1 plus $5 a day. If X equals the amount of number of days, what is the cost to rent a book for X amount of days?
Uh,
So the one and the five. The one is a dollar. You just walk up to the counter, dollar, right? Maybe the, I don't know why it costs a dollar, but it certainly needs to cost a dollar because that's the equation. It costs a dollar to, you know, file paperwork or something. It's just, that's just the way it is. Plus $5 every day. Do you see how Cody has taken the five and he's made it something that incorporates a change? You see what I mean? Something that can change. The $1 can't change, right? It costs a dollar. But the changing part, it should change because as X changes, something should change. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
As X changes, something should change, right? So as X changes, well, first of all, what is X?
Days.
And what is Y?
The amount.
What? Amount of what things?
The cost.
The cost, yeah, the dollars, the total cost. So as the number of days increases, what happens?
The more it costs. The more it costs.
Every day that goes by, how much more does it cost?
$5.
$5 more every day. You see what we're calling, what we'll call here a rate of change. When we're looking at these kinds of equations, it's going to happen all the time. We're going to see a rate in there. Something needs to incorporate change. As something changes, something else needs to change. In this case, the number of days goes by, causes the number of dollars to go up. Does somebody else have an example like this? Okay. I gave you a vague prompt, but we're going to be ready for the next one. This one is Cody's. Jasper, can we use yours?
I don't think so. It didn't make sense to me, so.
It doesn't make sense to you? I think we need to tweak it a little bit from what I read. But if you'll just start reading it, if you're willing to, then it's definitely got potential. Is that all right?
Yeah, I don't understand it. So.
Okay, well, we'll talk about it.
I'd rather not.
Okay, I'm going to write a story like your story, not exactly like your story. I'll put a little asterisk here. We collaborated on it. You said something like, every day that goes by, five puppies.
Yeah. Five tacos.
Maybe five puppies are born?
Sure.
Is that maybe a shelter or something? Or shelter where you usually let dogs get born there? I don't know. Maybe it's a breeding farm.
Breeding farm.
Breeding
farm. Anyway.
Dog.
Every day that goes by, five puppies are born. Okay? So that's a rate, isn't it? It's five. What per what? Five puppies per day. You see that rate? It's incorporating a change. What's changing here?
The amount of puppies per day.
The amount of puppies per day is staying the same.
Oh.
The amount of puppies is changing, right? Why is the amount of puppies changing?
Because every day there's five that are born.
So there's the number of puppies is changing because the number of days is changing.
Yes, right.
Number of days changes, number of puppies changes. In a positive way, right? Days go by, puppies go up, days go by, puppies go up. Okay? So let's talk about this. What does X represent then?
Days.
What does Y represent?
Puppies.
Total puppies. What have we not clarified here?
Puppies all together.
Yes.
That's puppies all together right there, total puppies. This is the number of days.
The days of...
What part of this has not been used in this story?
Jasper?
Plus one. What about plus one?
Plus one.
What's that?
One odd puppy.
What's going on?
Nothing.
And why is there talking about it?
Right?
It's like one odd puppy out of the five. Or there's like there's one puppy that lives my
difference.
That would be mine, this is true. All of the puppies over there live.
Yeah.
Plus one.
When you hear Sid.
One bunch of tan dogs and then one black dog. Orange dogs.
Okay,
that
can work. So, black
dogs.
Shh. You're like average right now. Five tan puppies per day, plus there's one black puppy that was just hanging out there from the beginning.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And that's fine, that works. And then, you know, a tan puppy, a black puppy, they're all puppies, we had them all together, we got a bunch of puppies. Okay, I also heard Dustin suggested there's one because of what?
Another mother dog?
Well, just the mother itself. Right? Plus the one, so now you could say, if you just say dogs in general, like why is the number of dogs? Because we're counting the one that was the mother dog.
Oh.
This is a busy mother dog having five puppies per day. But sometimes
that would be a little,
That would be a little bit excessive.
Okay.
It's
a super puppy, super dog.
Laughter is fine, that's great. It's the extended jibber jabbers. So, yeah, it would have to be genetically engineered to produce. But you get the idea. Like, these stories you have to write, sometimes they're a little silly because we have to, well, what's this one mean? And I don't know, mom, well, that's kind of weird. But it's what you can do. It's the best you can do. And what I'm looking for is that you've incorporated a rate, right? This thing is a rate, and this thing is just like, what would you call this one? extra, the amount you started with,
excess.
Right?
The
excess.
The extra runt.
This part right here, extra runt, the extra, whatever, like just this one other one that's just there. It's not that we're getting another one every day, right? It doesn't change. It is just a fixed amount, the $1 it costs to rent the book. The one puppy that was just there from the beginning, it was already there. Just the one thing that was already there, and we add on to it. We add on to it as time goes by. Okay, very good. Very good. Very good stories. Okay, let's try again and write a story based on this equation right here. Use this equation. Now that you've gotten an idea of what I'm looking for, write another story. Notice there's a little difference there, and so you have to think about it. What in the world could that, how can we incorporate that different aspect of this equation? And we'll see how it works. Go ahead.
Okay. There were a certain number of mooses, and then I saw three more groups of the same number of moose. And then six moose went away, just for the fun of it. And why would equal the number of moose that were still?
Something that I see common among all of the things that I read, which is good, is that we saw, six went away.
Six left.
No, this is right.
Okay.
Six went away. You lost six. There is a negative amount, right? There is an amount that we took away that we lost. Okay? It made the total amount go down. Okay? I see a lot of that. We're still not quite all getting the 3 times x part, okay? Six have to go away. We have to lose six. But then, what could the 3 represent, Cole?
Oh, I was just
going to
say something else, but...
How many more points?
I stayed there 3 days, for 3 days.
What's that?
I went hunting for 3 days.
Hunting for 3 days?
So
if you went hunting for 3 days, why would you multiply that by x?
So a plumber charges $3 an hour, and you have a coupon that is $6 off the total cost.
Nice.
What is the total cost?
Cheater. So in this case, what? Six of what went away? Six of what things? Dollars.
Monies.
Okay. So,
Cody.
So, $3 per hour is what the plumber charges, but you have this coupon that just takes $6 away. Does it take $6 away every hour?
No.
No. Does it take $6 away every day?
No.
It just subtracts. Right, reduces the total amount by $6. You see? See how we have that rate? We talked about that rate. Okay? So, here's the thing. The amount of money that you pay, the amount of money that he has, is going up by $3 every hour. But, right off the bat, you have a coupon that drops it down for 6 hours. So, how long does he have to work before he even has money?
Shh. 1 hour.
1 hour?
2 hours.
3 hours?
No.
An hour.
An hour for $3, but remember you had the coupon that you lose, you take $6 off?
He needs to work 3 hours.
He needs to work for 2 hours.
Well, 2 hours, but then he gets no money.
He's at no money. So I guess you have to work for, I see what you're saying, to have money. You would really have to work for like 2 point anything, right? Anything bigger than 2, he's up in the positive amount of dollars. Okay. That's a terrible coupon. For you, it's great. If you can keep the amount of work under 2 hours, he has to give you money when he leaves. And usually plumbers charge more than $3 an hour. Sometimes these stories are kind of funny, but it's a perfect example of what these numbers represent. Okay? What we have here is a rate of change, and here we have what we could call an initial amount. I'm going to start sending people to the office. It's getting ridiculous. You all know that you're taking away from class by talking. You're not adding to it. I don't need people taking away from class. I need people adding to class. If you continue to take away from class, the next person who does, I will ask you to leave. You don't want to, because I don't want you to not be here. But you're taking away from class. Stop doing it. Making noises with your mouths, making people laugh is not the goal of this class. So we have what we could call a positive rate of change. Positive rate of change. Every time the number of hours goes forward, increases, the number of dollars also increases. So we have a positive rate. And we have a negative initial amount. Maybe you've had some time to think about it. Could someone come up with another example? That's it.
You
just gained 3 pounds? 3 pounds? why would we multiply that 3 pounds by x? Can we tweak it a little bit? Can we change the story just a little bit so that it's not just You gain 3 pounds.
3 pounds a day.
Every day.
Oh, goodness. 3 pounds a day.
What?
That's fast.
3 pounds.
But at least I get 3 pounds every day.
A year of cocaine.
Okay. Now what's this minus six? What would this minus six represent?
You dropped 6 pounds.
Dropped 6 pounds, so you started at, start at 6 pounds below your goal weight. I mean, you can't start at -6 pounds. It'd be impossible. You'd be a helium balloon or something. You start at 6 pounds below your target weight. What we're trying to see here, though, is that this story has to be set about something that is going up as time goes by, but that also starts out at, you know, below, less, down. There has to be a loss of something initially. Okay. I had somebody in the last class say that there was a plant that grows 3 inches per month. All right. So if this plant grows 3 inches per month, then what could this negative six represent?
Cool. Like, if they cut it, then it could drop 6 inches?
You could cut it, and it could drop 6 inches. That could absolutely work for it. So what when we start out, but what if it starts as a seed? Like, there's nothing to cut when it's a seed. How could we have a minus six height?
Just not
cutting. Well, how about, because 3 inches per month times X months is going to tell us how many inches it grew, right? So when we minus six, we should be minusing not 6 days but, or 6 months, but 6 inches, right? So how about if it starts out in a hole that's 6 inches deep, right? And it's growing the whole time, but it's underground, and then after 2 months, it gets to the very surface, and then it starts to have a positive height. Okay, let's do it again for a third equation. Stories, something to the effect of, you start with $2. Okay. Then I saw spend, the word spend, right? What happens when you spend money? How much money do you have? More or less?
Less.
Right? Or you lose. How much are we losing?
$4.
$4.
$4. When?
When you shop.
Every something. Every day. Every week, every hour. Every 5 years. But every something, say every day. That's how we incorporate this negative, right? This is what we call a negative rate of change. Going down. Have a good day.
Thanks.
Tomorrow.